Hello everyone, my name is Soraya and I do all the filming for my husband Terry aka Stutzman52. If you like this video or any other video on Stutzman52's channel, click on the subscribe button, then click on the settings button. Check it off and then click on the save button. Now you'll be notified by email of any new video uploads for this channel. Thank you.
All right, now this is the original. Like I said before, this is metal. It's got three little metal tabs on it. And it's got, looks like a rubber embedded into this here metal, kind of like a washer. Now, this one is from Felpro. Now this thing is nothing but paper. And I am just kind of a little bit worried about this, but and this one here, you can Google all you want. You will never find it. I looked through hundreds of pictures, and I don't know if I went to the dealership and got this, but you can't see a picture. Only thing you see is a pictorial diagram. So I don't know even then what I would get. It might come in like this. So anyway, it's supposed to work, so we're gonna put it on. Hopefully this thing won't leak. There is no locating tabs or nothing on here, so as you can see. So to hold this thing in place, I'm going to use a little bit of RTV sealant, kind of hold this thing in place.
Huh.
That's what I see.
Pretty colors.
I like this color.
Uh-huh.
It's so good, isn't it?
You're just having way too much fun.
Too much fun to stop and have some, yeah. Now,
all right.
I don't know which side goes which, probably don't matter. I'm going to put it down like this. Okay.
Looks good.
Yep, and we do not need that joker to slip when we put this thing on there. Okay. I'll make sure it's centered around the hole.
Okay.
We got a little bit of excess on the top. That'll be fine. Okay. All right. Okay. That Felpro gasket for the water pump housing is 35619. Okay. Now here's the bolts for the water pump housing. I am going to be putting on some high temperature thread sealant, because it looked like there was a little bit of coolant on these bolts.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just going to put a little bit on there before we put this stuff in. Josie, you and your hair.
Leave my doggy alone.
I'll tell you what. Okay. Let's get that on there pretty good. I think that looks good. Maybe we can put Josie's hair along with the bolt.
it might keep everything in place.
Keep everything in place.
Yeah. I just brushed the dogs yesterday.
Yeah, I tell you. They should.
Absolutely.
Look at her. More damn hair. Look at that.
The problem with long-haired white dogs.
Yep. Let's get that crap off of there.
Do you hear that, Yingy? Do you hear your daddy talking about your hair, baby girl? Oh.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, just for the guys that did not watch about the helicoil. So the helicoil has been installed, so it's right in there. Okay?
Uh-huh.
All right. All right. Two bolts on the water pump housing, 15 foot-pounds of torque. And also be sure to get your hose, lower radiator hose back on there too. And get your, you know, get your spring clamp there. I'm going to go and I'm going to loosen up the bolts here on these two camshaft sprockets. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take this on out. To get access to the front of these here camshaft sprockets with these bolts, you can see it's pretty tight. You can't even, by the time you start putting adapters and your pull handle and your Torx fitting, or even maybe try to get a impact wrench down in there, and these bitches are tight too, so you want all the access you can. So anyway, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this here mount out. This is not gonna be in the service manual. It's gonna be three bolts, 13 millimeter socket will take care of it. There's one over here,
That is one right up here. But before you can get to this one, you can see that these here two lines are over top of this bolt. Mm-hmm. So what you have to do is come back here on the back side. You'll see these here two straps for these two lines. They're connected on this stud. 10 millimeter socket will take care of that for you. Now I've already got these here loosened up. So let me go ahead and I'll take them out. So there's one strap. Let me get my hand down in there. There's the second one. Now you'll be able to get to this one. You can pull the lines back. There's one bolt. There's that second bolt down here. All three bolts are the same thing. Same size. You can see what they look like. And then, let's just lift it out of there. So now that'll free this area up in here to give us more room. All right, as you know, we're gonna try to break these crankshaft, these camshaft bolts out, all right? Now when you do that, you wanna be sure to take your bar out that's holding and locking down the camshafts. You don't want that bar to be in there. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, if you try to use the bar to lock these camshafts, then you could stand a chance of them twisting. I'll tell you that in the service manual. So get rid of your bar. Now, you're going to come down here on this end. Now, in the manual, it'll say, use a wrench and lock and hold down the camshaft hex. There should be a hex shape here to put a wrench around. Take a look. Look on either camshaft. Do you see anything for a hex shape to put a wrench on?
Mm-mm.
There is nothing. So, how are you going to hold this thing? So what you got to do is you're going to have to get a camshaft sprocket holder. Now I'll show you what I used. I've already got these bolts loose. I'm using this one right here. Okay. Now basically, this tool will come with an assortment of different size pins. This is what I used. And you will go inside the slots and you will find your spot there. And I had Soraya to hold this here, and she was holding it down. And then I used a half inch pull bar. Okay, in fact, let me show you what I got. And this is what I used. Now this is a impact, this is a T55. That's what size these here bolts are, Torx. And they got the spec says that they'll be torqued from 48 to 52 foot-pounds of torque. And I can assure you, these were a lot tighter than that. So whoever was here before, and I'm sure they, we already know they changed the timing belt. So right. I don't know, they probably put an impact wrench on here to tighten these up because it was tighter than whale shit. All right, probably 100 foot-pounds of torque. It was everything I could do to break these things, and that was using a half-inch pull bar. So if you got a 3/8 pull bar, forget it. My recommendation is get a half inch impact tool. And if it was too tight for me to do then I was gonna get put an impact tool down in there and see if I could break it loose. But fortunately I was able to do it by hand. Now you're thinking about how you gonna get an impact tool in there. Okay, so what I did, if I had to go that route, I'll show you what I was gonna use. Which would have been this tool right here. So Onyx, this is a half inch drive. I think it puts out around 430 foot pounds of torque. So it was either gonna strip that bolt or it was gonna take it out, one or the other. So that's why we removed this here other part of this mount, just in case I had to, so I could get in there. Now once you break the bolts loose, you'll see now that at a freewheel, there is no pin locking the camshaft sprocket to the camshaft. That's for both of them, okay? Now, you may be asking or wondering, why are we loosening up these bolts?
Yeah.
The reason is that Ford wants you that when you route this new timing belt on there, imagine that you got your belt. Let me go get the belt and it'll make it clear. All right, now when we put the timing belt back on, remember, the camshafts are locked down with the bar. Now you might be lucky. Now, I did a test run on mine, and I wasn't. You might be. But let's say that you start this here timing belt. Now, you start down on the crankshaft sprocket, and you go around. And let's say you're coming up here around this here crankshaft, a camshaft sprocket. All right. You have these ribs on the belt. Now, of course, these ribs has got to fit right down in there in these here, in these valleys. Okay. Now, what are you going to do when you come around and then that this does not line up with the camshaft ribs?
Oh.
Now.
Yeah, now it makes sense.
Now you're forced to break these bolts. Then you route the belt and you can turn this here, freewheel it to get your belt so it'll line up, so your belt ribs line up onto the camshaft sprockets. Remember, the whole time these camshafts are locked down. So you cannot turn the camshafts. You're only left with one thing. And that's it. You gotta have to turn these camshaft sprockets, which of course means you gotta loosen these bolts.
Gotcha.
Okay, so that's the reason why we loosen up those bolts. All right, now once you break the camshaft sprockets are loose, then the only way that you're going to be able to get this bar back in, you're going to have to turn these camshafts. Well, as I mentioned before, there is no hex shape in here where you can put a wrench on. Now, the manual says use locking pliers, okay? So, the best place I found, and I'm using some vise grips, and I found this here area, look where I'm at. You'll see there's a little lug here, and you'll clamp around that, and then you will take in, turn your camshaft, and then slide your bar in. Now I'm going to show you this one here on this one. Right here, you can see there's a little bar, a little nub down here, a little area right there. This is where I can get the vise grips on, okay? So I'm going to clamp right around there. That one I need to snug it up a little bit. Now, let's go back over here and turn this one and see if we can get this bar in.
Oh.
All right. So now, both camshafts are locked down. So now we can take our vise grips out. Now these camshaft sprockets look the same, but don't assume anything, at least I don't. So I've marked this here I for intake and E for exhaust. Now I'm going to just take these sprockets off. I just want to look at the camshaft seals. Now let's pull the exhaust camshaft sprocket off.
I would have done it as L and R, left or right. But...
Okay.
Yep.
That's what this bolt. Now you know, you look right in here. I saw this before. But if you guys have already had your timing belt changed, you might want to inspect this. Because this is what I was worried about, that this thing was going to actually strip out even more. And then I'd have really had a problem with me. Okay, so take note of that before you maybe break it. All right, we're going to be replacing the camshaft seals along with the crank seal. This is a tools kit that I'm going to be using.
New toy.
Something new to play with. Now for the camshaft seals, we're going to be using these two short pullers. For the crankshaft seal, we're going to be using the long ones. So I'm going to get out the two short ones.
Little picks.
Yeah, you can see how they go in.
Yeah.
Go in on the side of the seal, you push that in, then you turn it up. You do that on the other side of the seal, and then we'll use this puller here, and we'll pull it out, pull the seal out. Now what I like to do is I like to put a little clean engine oil right here on this here 90 degree lip. Just makes it a little bit easier pushing it in on the side of the seal up next to the camshaft. Let me get my hand down in there. That's one.
Huh.
And then we're going to take the other one. If I can get my hand over there, push it in and then turn it up. Okay.
And now the piece de resistance.
Let me back that out a little bit. Now, so I got a little bit of oil here on this tip of this cone.
Pretty interesting.
Now let's get a wrench. Can't get my hands down in there. Starting to coming out.
Yeah, see that.
And there she is.
Wow.
So there you go. Alright, now what we're going to do now is we have to install the new seals. So we're going to use the camshaft bolt, we're going to use one of them, to push the new seal back into its bore. So with this kit, we find a spacer that will fit the bolt. In this case, it's an M10. And it's got it roped right up on here for the different size bolts. Okay, so that one fits.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this adapter will be used in all cases. Okay, and what we will do here is we will take that and drop it in there. Now, we take our old seal and we're going to find a mandrel that's going to fit that. And it looks like that's going to do it. Then we take our bolt, we put it back into here, and then this
should sit right
on. Fit that, and then that will go over there. We will take that, screw into the end of the camshaft, and the idea is that when we tighten on this bolt, it will take that seal and push it right on into the bore. All right.
Now, what would you do if you didn't have that nice kit?
Well, there's several different ways that you can get these seals in and out. Now, one way is you can take a screwdriver, wedge in there. You may want to put a little piece of tape on the end of your screwdriver so that you'll protect the shaft, mm-hmm, or the journal, you should say, of the camshaft or the crankshaft snout. You go in and then you kind of wedge it out. Now, they also have seal removal tools where you can get in there and you can just kind of wedge this thing on out of there. But then you got to be careful with them because you could damage the aluminum block or, you know, the on the side of the where you're pulling this tool against. Another way is you could actually drill a small hole in here, then put a self-tapping screw in there, get some vise grips, and then just kind of yank on it.
Yeah.
Or you could put a little tool under the screw, use a fulcrum, and then kind of wedge it out. All this take a little bit of time, but this here is a pretty fast way to do it, and then also ensures that, you know, you don't damage the, you know, the shaft that you're trying to get out.
Well, how would you put it back in then if you didn't have that thing?
Well,
you
can take a socket, find a socket that will fit this right here, the outside of the diameter of the seal, and then you can just take a hammer and just tap it in. Of course, when you get it started, you know, get it square, and then you could tap the socket and you're good. Another way that you can do it is you can actually, I just did this for demonstration to show you guys, you can actually take and cut you a piece of PVC, and that's got to be square. So what I did here is I cut it off in a compound saw, miter saw, and then this will fit over the outside, this will match the diameter of the seal.
You tap it in.
So like I said, I was going to demonstrate this for the crank, okay, then you get your washer. Then you'll get your bolt. And it'll work similar to what this tool is going to do. In this case, what you do is you tighten it in, and then as you tighten it in, then it's going to push the seal right on in. So it's all kind of different ways you could do it. Okay. This is the motor craft. camshaft seal number, if anyone's interested. Of course, you can get generic seals out there also. And let's go ahead and we'll take them out. There's our new seal. One of them, anyway. All right, first thing I'm going to do is I want to lube up this here inside of this here lip.
Just regular engine oil.
Clean engine oil. You can also use grease. Doesn't matter. And I'm also going to do the outside too. So just help it make it go inside and to keep this lip from, this inner lip from rolling. Okay. Now, needless to say, you want to make sure that your journal here for the camshaft that the seal rides on is going to be in good shape. I had a little bit of slight rust here right where the seal was sitting at. So I took some 400 grit sandpaper and I took and went around that, lightly sanding it. Also, you want to make sure that your bore is cleaned out. Now, over here on this one, I'm going to get ready to put this here seal in. Now, when you put the seal on by hand, you want to make sure that this inner seal, the lip that goes around and contacts the shaft, is not going to be rolled over. So you have to kind of like make sure that that doesn't happen. All right, let me get this here tool on here, and we'll finish putting it on up in there. And let me get a ratchet. T55 will take care of that.
Now you're just pushing it in.
Yeah, and you got to make note of how these seals were installed. In my case, they were a flush. So that's what I'm going to try to do here. It looks like a little bit more. Take it back off. Let's take a look at it. Okay, this seal here is installed. Looks pretty square. So I'm going to be working on the next one now. All right, same thing down here. I removed the seal, got a new one installed. All right, on the crankshaft snout, I put a very small amount of anti-seize up on top of the key and a very small amount around the shaft. Make this thing a little bit easier coming off. Okay. And just put the bolt back just to make sure he's still there. By the way, this is the forward part number for the crankshaft seal, if anyone is interested. Okay. Alright, I'm going to get ready now. I'm going to put the timing pin in. We're going to get this thing set up to top dead center for number one piston. Now what I've done here, if you look at this here word front, right above the letter O, you can see I put a mark here on that tooth. Now, when I'm at top dead center, it is that mark will line up right in the middle of this here big old half a round dimple here. So that way I know if I ever get off of top dead center, I can just come back and look at these two marks and I can tell. Okay, so now I'm going to get ready to put the timing pin in. All right, here's a long timing pin. I'm getting ready to screw it in on the side of the block. Okay. As before, screw it in, screw it all the way down. No wrenches are needed. All right, I'm gonna turn the crank clockwise until it hits up on the side of the pin. There it is. We're at top dead center on number one. Now, I need to align the slots. They're up on the top, but they're off just a hair, so I can get this bar in there. And I've showed you this here with the vise grip, so I'm not going to go over that again. There's one. Now let me come back over here. Get this one. All
Looks like he needs to come back a little bit. All right, both camshafts are locked down now. All right, so for this job, I'm going to be using a Chloe's timing belt kit. And part number for that is a BK294A. Ooh, look at there. Okay, now with this one here, this kit, you will actually get two idlers. But this is applying for another type of vehicle, so we're not using that one. But we are going to use this one. Mm-hmm. And we're going to use, of course, the tensioner. Now, I can tell you right now that I did have a Gates. I had picked a Gates out, and I had put the kit on. I had put the belt on, but the problem was that the belt was not tracking to where it should have been. In fact, it was coming off the edge of the roller about an eighth of an inch. So the tensioner from Gates is totally different from what was on the car. So I did not know what was on the car first, so I went ahead and ordered the Gates. And so now I'm going to use this here kit. All right. The other thing I didn't like about the Gates kit, that the bearings, you know, they were made in China. But if you look on the box, it says that they were made in Canada. All right. The only thing I saw that was made in Canada was the tensioner housing assembly, but not the bearing. So, and belt, I said it was made in the USA. Even then, you know, even if something says made in the USA, you cannot be guaranteed that it actually was made in the USA. A lot of equipment today, even where I work at, they'll ship the equipment, the molds, and everything is, you know, of course, like the molds that'll say made in USA. It'll ship it over to China or ship it down to Mexico, and those they're still use those same molds. So you'll see made in USA when actually it's made in a different country. Let me just show you what the Gates timing detentioner. Let me show you what that looks like. All right, the one on the left is from Chloe's. The one on the right is from Gates. You can see the difference right away. Take a look at these here brackets, you see? Mm-hmm. See the difference in how far this one is protruding? Look at the difference in the width, okay? Take a round, look at the back side. You can get a little bit difference in it.
Mm-hmm.
This one here, I compared it to the original, the one from Chloe's, and it is dead on the money of being what it should look like. So therefore, I'm not gonna be using this one because I could not get this belt to track right. Okay, so let's get started. Put this here timing belt idler on. I'm going to be putting a little bit of Loctite on there. And let's go down there and get her in. Make sure your hands are clean. No grease, no oil, nothing like that. You want to keep all these idlers clean. You want to torque this one up to 18 foot-pounds or 25 newton meters. That looks good. All right, let's get our tensioner now. A little bit of Loctite. And let's screw him in. You'll have to use your original bolt. It doesn't come in the kit. Now, I want to leave this here tab. I want to leave it loose so that I can pivot this here tensioner around. Because if I was to take this here tab and drop it into that notch right there, we would never get this timing belt on. So I'm going to leave it just like so. Put our camshaft bolts back in. And put a little blue thread locker on it. Let's do the same for the other camshaft bolt. All
And you want to leave both your bolts loose at this point right now. Okay. We're getting ready to put the timing belt on. At this point, make sure you got your camshaft bars in there. You got your camshafts locked down. You got your timing pin. You got it number one piston at top dead center. So you're all set. So what we're going to do is going to be hard for me to show you this. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start down on the crankshaft sprocket. And I'm going to come up over this here idler. I'm going to go around this here exhaust camshaft sprocket, go around the intake camshaft sprocket, and then I'm going to come around on the tensioner. Okay? Now that, I'm going to use a Chloe's belt. You see this belt here, it's made in Germany.
Made in Deutschland.
What, yeah? Speak some German for us.
99.
Come on, you can do better than that.
10-10.
10-10. Say a phrase, how are you in German?
Wie geht es Ihnen?
All right, whatever that meant. All right, now you can see the belt is on there. And the whole idea of this is to let these here camshaft sprockets float so that it will just find itself there, okay? Now, the tang that's down here that's on the tensioner, remember where I kept it out of the notch? Mm-hmm. It's on the block. So if I can find it, we're gonna take that, I'm gonna swivel it around, if I can get my hand in there, and then we're gonna drop it in the notch. And it is, all right. Okay. Now, it's going to be very difficult to show you what I'm going to be doing on the car because my hands are going to be in the way. So I'm going to show you with this old tensioner what is going to be happening here. This inner part right here, this here metal tab, it has a hex shape opening here. You want to get a 6mm Allen wrench. You're going to be putting that in there. Now, what's going to happen is you're going to move this. Now, this will be up next to the belt. So once you move this, you're tensioning and up the belt and you're loosening it, depending on which direction you go. Now, as you turn this, and your bolt's gonna be loose when you do this, as you do that, you will notice that this right here, you want to put this notch, you're gonna see it, this move, this assembly here, because remember, this is fixed into the notch in the block. So this will move as you turn this here. Now, you want to take the center of the notch here, and it's gonna be very hard to see, but there's a line that's scribed right here. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. This is the old one here.
Yeah.
So you want to be able to move that and get it right up into the center, that line in the center of that notch. Now, while you're holding this in place to keep that right there, then you want to tighten this bolt to 18 foot-pounds, or 25 newton meters, okay?
It's a juggling act.
It's a juggling act. So that's what I'm gonna be doing next, okay? As I said, once you get it to the, you get the notch up into the middle of the, where the line's at, hold it in place with the Allen wrench and torque it up to 18 foot-pounds. And there we go. What I'm doing now is I got a mirror down there. I'm taking a look at it. Just want to make sure that everything still looks good. Make sure the line is still in the notch. And mine looks pretty good, okay? All right, what I've got right here now is Soraya is holding the camshaft sprocket. The bar is still in place. I got a torque wrench. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna torque this up. I'm gonna start with the intake camshaft bolt. I'm gonna torque it up to 15 foot-pounds. This will keep this here sprocket from moving around. All right, you ready? All right, just hold it, but don't turn it. Just hold it in place. All right, that's 15 foot-pounds. Now, we're gonna move over to the exhaust sprocket. Let me find a spot here for you. Okay, looks like right. Yeah, let me see here. finding a spot here. Nope. Let's try it right there. Let's try that. Just hold it in place. Okay. Right there. Let me see if I can get that. Again, same thing, 15 foot-pounds. All right, ready, Saray?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now we'll take that one out. There you go. And now I'm gonna take the bar out from the camshaft. All right, Saraya, she's holding the intake cam sprocket, and we're going to do a final torque up on these of 50 foot-pounds. All right, hold it, Saraya. Ready?
Yep.
All right, and now let's do the one for the intake. I think probably maybe right there. Okay. Again, 50 foot-pounds. Next step, we're taking out the timing pin. Now we're going to turn the crank two complete turns. Now we'll put it up on sauce. Stop just a hair. Let's get our timing pin, put him back in place. Turn the crank till the bottom is up next to the pin. Now what you want to do is see if you can get your bar back into the slots. If you see that you can get one, but maybe not the other, and it's then what you may have to do is you may have to go back and loosen up your camshaft sprocket bolt, turn the cam, get it back in, lock it back down, and then go from there. In my case, it worked okay.
Woohoo!
Now, what we want to do is we want to check our tensioner to make sure that it hasn't moved. And mine has moved just a little bit, so I'm going to go back and I'm going to readjust it to get that notch so it's right in the middle of that line. So that's what I'm going to do in the next step. Okay, I just got through adjusting the tensioner, so we want to recheck everything again. So we're going to go down, we're going to take out the timing pin, and then I'm going to take out the bar. I'm going to make two revolutions, and right before it gets up near the top dead center, I'm going to screw the pin back in, I'm going to put the bar back in, and then I'm going to make sure everything lines up, the bar goes in, and then I'm going to recheck the tensioner, because as you turn it, you want to make sure that that tensioner stays right where it's going to be at, where you adjusted it. So that's what I'm going to do right now.
That's a lot of dang trouble.
It's a finicky thing here, going back and forth, but I got to make sure this thing is right. I think Ford's idea about this is by doing it this way, you'll get a lot more accurate timing than if you use just marks, because, you know, you can kind of be a little bit off, you know, here or there. Mm. It's always kind of judgmental about where the mark might be at, might be a little bit off. This way, you'll be dead on the money. And, you know, because we're locking the crank, you know, up against the pin, top dead center for number one. Then we're also ensuring that the camshafts are locked in place. So, you know, this is what they want, so it's a finicky thing. But you got to make sure that everything falls back to where you want it, you know. So let me take the pin out, as I said, take out the bar. Well, I'm going to turn it two cranks, two turns of the crank, and then I'm going to, you know, put the pin back in. See if the bar, make sure to go back in on the slots. and then recheck the tensioner and make sure it is where it's supposed to be. All right, so you guys already seen that step, what I've just done before earlier. So that's what I'm gonna do. So that's where I'm gonna be at right now. Guys, here's a shot of what you should have. You see the line? You can see that it's inside the middle of the notch. So that's what you wanna shoot for when this thing is all done. All right, so I went through that procedure. Everything is looking good. The tensioner is looking good. The bar goes into slots and it's up next to the pin on the crank. So I think we're done with the timing belt. Now we can move on to the next step. One final thing. You remember I told you about the Gates tensioner and the belt was trying to walk? Well, this belt was actually way out here on the outside edge of this sprocket, and down there on the tensioner pulley and down on the idler pulley, it was about an eighth of an inch past the front edge of these here pulleys. And so I'm looking at that now, and it looks really good. Mm-hmm. You can see that the belt's tracking right in the center of the sprockets. They're centered pretty much right on the pulleys down there, so everything is looking good. So my recommendation is I would not get Gates to try to use that for your tensioner. I would stay with coils, so it looks like this is turning out pretty good with coils. Now that you got everything timed up, now you can go ahead and take out the timing pin, and also you can take out your camshaft locking bar. I heard somebody say they were getting tired.
Yeah, your face looks a little red. It's time for a break.
No, I was talking about one of the YouTubers. I heard him crying.
Ah.
He wants a break. Let's take a break, guys. We got the timing belt on here. Got it all adjusted. This video is probably turning out close to 39, 40 minutes. So trying to maintain them a little bit shorter. Anyway, so let's go ahead and wrap it up. And the next one, we'll start be putting more of this stuff on this vehicle here. Any final words for us, Soraya?
I just want to get her done.
In German?
No.
Say one thing. Just say anything at all.
Ich liebe dich.
Oh.
Means I love you.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't know how to say that. Okay. Ditto. How about that?
Okay.
All right. You guys take care. We'll see you in the next one.